speed limit. It was 55. But he was going 35. 35 is a lot slower than 55, especially when you're in your car on your way to work. And I decided to pass him on in a passing lane. I barely got the car up to 60 miles an hour to pass him, barely over the speed limit. That's how slow he was going. Right when my car came up even to his, a car came over the crest farther down the road. Now, this was a legal passing lane. And as soon as my car came even with his, he accelerated past me. I was easily passing him. Then suddenly he accelerated. I accelerated to match, but my timing was off. So now I'm running out of passing lane, and there's a car coming the other way. In that moment, I realized and took a quick look to my side. He was giving it all he had. He was trying to run me into the other car or force me to go back. My car had a much larger engine, and I was more determined, I guess. I sped up and got around him, and I passed him just in time before either myself or the driver coming the other way had to make a rather fateful decision to brake or get off the road. The true intentions of this person were then now known as he brighted my car and rode my tail bumper all the way down the road. He stayed completely tight against my car, brighting me the whole way. This went on for a few minutes, and I expected him to back off. We even passed a police officer further down the road, and he did back off a little bit. But as soon as we got past the police officer, he rode me again. Now I knew his intentions were fully committed to harassing me for some slight I made in passing him. I thought about the possible actions and brake checking him where you slam on your brakes would have been a bad decision. I don't want to be involved with this person, and especially if he wrecks into my car. I don't want to deal with him. So I have to think how I would handle this. How would I handle this? Well, it didn't take me long to figure out a plan of attack. I waited till we came up to a hill, and I accelerated very quickly, very fast, where I knew there was rarely any police presence. And I accelerated very far in front of him with the intention of turning into a local restaurant. And I did so. It looked, the restaurant being on the corner, it looked like I turned right at the stop sign. But in fact, I turned into the parking lot of the restaurant, swung my car around, and waited for him. Of course, I didn't have to wait long for him to come up to the stop sign. And when he did, I pulled out right behind him with a little beep of the horn and flicked on my brights. Being that I was in an SUV that sat quite higher than his car, my lights shined directly into his car and illuminated his face perfectly as he drove past me. He looked right at me when I beeped, pulled out behind him. He looked right around his shoulder. And I gave him a wave, whether he could see me or not. I was waving like, how do you like me now? How do you like me now, you little bitch? My answer didn't take long to receive. He accelerated through the stop sign into the circle as fast as he could, sped off, and went down an alternate road. It wasn't on my way to work, so I let him go. I was, after all, trying to go out and make a living. I didn't have time for this crap. But my message was definitely delivered. I don't think he thought I'd have the presence of mind to turn the tables on him. But I did. And I think sometimes we don't think about what our actions might be and how, if we bully someone or pick on someone or torment someone, how quickly those tables can turn. And when they do, he found himself at quite the disadvantage. It's amazing to see what flight and fright can do to human beings' ability to drive a car very, very fast. This troubled me. This situation troubled me, and I dwelled on it a little bit. It piqued my mind. I couldn't remember why. So when I was on my way home, I called my son. I was on my way home like 8 hours later. I called my son and I told him about the situation I had where a guy, when I tried to pass him, accelerated and almost drove me into the other car coming the other way. And he said, don't you remember that happened to me on the same road? I thought about it. And that's where I remember this. That's where I remember this happening. So he told me about his situation. It was similar time of night, similar direction, same road, same exact state route, same color car, young kid. In my son's case, he barely got around the guy. And then the guy rode him, riding him all the way down the road. And I thought, oh, you nasty little troll. Not good enough to almost run my son and myself into oncoming traffic. You think this little intimidation game is going to get you far? Okay. Well, I told my son my solution to this problem, and he found it quite hilarious. So I set up a little thing called an experiment, because all things, if they're facts, are testable. I waited till the very next Saturday, same time, and left. Sure as hell, there he was. Now we're gonna have some fun. I'm gonna get to the bottom of this little problem. I went up the same road, and sure as the hair that's still left on top of my head, he did the same thing. He slowed down to 35. Well, this time we're gonna have some fun. I put on my brights and I beat my horn the same way I did last time. Now I'm gonna ride you, baby, baby. I think he got a little tiny penny to drop in his head. I was ready for him to brake check me. I figured that might be his little routine. Get you to ride him, then bam, hit the brakes. Now I'm in trouble for wrecking into him. But I was surprised. He remembered me. Oh, precious. He remembered me. I never seen somebody accelerate so fast. He must have been going 90 miles an hour to pull away from me. And he took a side road and quickly disappeared into the Saturday night. It felt good that he remembered me. It felt good. He may have saw me pull out behind him. He may have been watching for me as much as I was watching for him. I suspect his behavior was starting to draw attention from others. I was just one of many, tired of his actions. I assume he'd been down this road before. But needless to say, he sure made my day. I was so happy that night. You know, it's all out there waiting for us. It's all out there waiting for you. You just have to make your way in life, and you'll find it. You'll find it. That's right. That's right. as Deadpool. And Deadpool is coming as well. My name is Dr. Andrew Michaels, and I'll always be here to help you. You're in my heart. Until I see all of you again, please have a most blessed day. Bye-bye.